1.5 minutes to go in the game, a 2-0 lead, and a man going into the penalty box for the Czechs. It will be number 29, Lukács. 2:30 to go. Soviet Union 2 and Czechoslovakia nothing. 2 minutes and 20 seconds remaining in the hockey game. Soviets on top, 2-0. And a tie for them is as good as a win when it comes to winning the gold. And the Czechs with an almost impossible task, down a man, and in effect down 3 goals in their bid for the gold medal. 2 minutes to go in the game. Kasatanov up ahead. Soviets not really looking to mount anything at this point. Just to utilize the rest of the clock. Drozdetsky skating in. And we'll have a face-off. So what it amounts to is that the Soviet Union, which entered Olympic hockey competition in 1956 and won the gold that year. They took the bronze medal in 60, won the gold in 64, 68, 72, 76, the silver in 80, and the gold again here.
You can see the anticipation on Coach Viktor Tikhonov's face. He was very heavily criticized. Look, he's still working his stopwatch now, checking how long the lines are on, even though there's only a minute and a half to go. But he was heavily criticized after Lake Placid, and there was some doubt whether he would remain as coach. But he is very much in control. And this is Viktor Tikhonov's team. This is a team that is made in his image as no veteran team can be. The 1980 team was the remnants of a past time. It was a team that was a veteran team. Tikhonov took over that veteran team and couldn't really put his stamp on it. This team plays very much the way he wants them to play. They are playing at a faster pace all the time. And with that faster pace, there is more body contact. And in a way, they're starting to put together the possession game and the pressure game. And you can see the results.
In this tournament now, the Soviet Union has outscored the opposition 48-5. They lead here 2-0. With a minute and 10 seconds remaining in the game, still 38 seconds remaining in the penalty to Erdin on Czechoslovakia. A lot of people, especially in the West, were very surprised that Tikhonov, after 1980, was given the opportunity, as Ken said, to remain as the coach. But the Soviets, the public and the press, look back upon 1980 as just one of those things, an aberration, and that may be so. It's something, of course, that the people who witnessed it in the United States will never forget. But here are the Soviets on the verge of recapturing the gold medal and doing it in very impressive fashion.
Although there are 10 players on this team that were on the team in 1980, the only player that remains from 1976, the only player who has a gold medal in his possession, is the goaltender Tretiak. And now he will have 3.
Sapporo, Innsbruck, and now he'll have one to take home from Sarajevo, Yugoslavia. Just 20 seconds remaining in the game. A goal in the first period, then an early goal in the second. 2-0 to score. It's one of those games in which the game is not really as close as the score would indicate necessarily. The Soviets controlled the pace and the tempo of the game, scored the 2 goals. Tretiak with a shutout, and the gold medal belongs to the Soviet Union.
You can hear the Soviet fans chanting "Molodtsi, Molodtsi, Bravo, Bravo." The team is a very deserving victor.
So the Soviet Union wins it. The final score 2-0.